Hello everybody and welcome back to Screen Stars. I'm here today to bring you my review for the 2018 political comedy thriller The Oath, a film that is written and directed by Ike Barinholtz and stars Ike Barinholtz and Tiffany Haddish, who we saw recently in the Kevin Hart film Night School. Now this is an odd beast of a film. This is, like I've said, it's a political comedy thriller. And I can't honestly think of the last time I've watched a comedy thriller, especially a political comedy thriller. And I genuinely didn't know what to expect when I was going to watch this film. I'd not heard anything about it. It seems to have disappeared from the face of the earth. No one's talking about it. And this film focuses on Ike Barinholtz's character, Chris, and his wife, Tiffany Haddish, Kai. And it focuses on, there is an announcement made by the government, and they're going to bring in something called the Oath, and they want people to sign up to this Oath, and if they do they get certain benefits, and if they don't, then even though they say, you know, it doesn't matter, you don't have to, clearly, you know, you're going to be missing out. So Ike Barinholtz's character, Chris, is a deeply political person, and he thinks it's absolutely disgusting that people are being asked to sign this oath and, you know, and to toe the line, and it's going to be like a police state, he thinks. And we go through, like, it goes to like 12 months later, and it's a Thanksgiving weekend, and he's got all his family over. And it's a Thanksgiving weekend, and it's the last weekend when people can sign the oath. And he thinks everybody in his family hasn't signed it. He's really against it. And there's all these news things on the TV of these riots going on and protests, people protesting against the oath. And it all seems to be going terribly wrong. And it causes serious problems in this household over the Thanksgiving weekend, to the point where it basically erupts into violence by the end of the weekend. Now then, what did I think of The Oath? I've got to say, I thought this was a weird, odd film. In the UK, the closest equivalent to this Oath thing that they're asked to do in America is probably the Brexit vote that we've had in this country. And if you know, if you're from the UK, you know very well what I'm talking about. If you're from outside the UK, you might have heard of Brexit. Basically, it was whether we got to choose whether we stayed in the European Union or left it, and we had the vote, and the vote was that we chose to leave the European Union. And that did a similar thing in this country. It caused a lot of upheaval and arguments in families as well. So that's the closest thing I can relate to this movie. A lot of people are comparing this as saying it's like they're having to go at Trump. I didn't get that impression with this film. But it is clearly given a message here, and it's clearly a very political film. That much is very, very clear. And I think it is quite cleverly written by Ike Barinholtz, and competently directed. And I'll be honest, I didn't realise he wrote and directed it until just preparing this review. So I think he did a decent job, and the acting throughout this is pretty good. It actually would have worked quite well as a stage play as well, I would think. But I think the execution here is a bit off. And that's only because I don't think comedy thrillers are a good combination. It's like having custard on toast, as far as I'm concerned. There are some moments in this film where you do genuinely have a little bit of a chuckle. You know, Ike Barinholtz is a talented comedy actor, and we've seen him in many vehicles, Neighbours and Blockers. And I'm glad he's getting his own vehicle. I just don't think this was the right thing. It is funny here and there, but then it goes sharply serious, and I mean properly serious, to the point where you're kind of, oh, what's going on, sort of thing. It gets quite shocking, and it turns into a genuine thriller at times, and it's quite jarring to go from lightheartedness to this thriller. I just found it really jarring, and it just didn't suit me. It didn't suit the film, for me. So it's not that I think this is a bad film, because I don't think it's a bad film. I think it's a very clever idea that doesn't necessarily work as a comedy thriller. It might have worked better just as a comedy or just as a thriller. Combining the two, I'm not sure was the best choice for this film, in my opinion. So I'm going to give this film a 5 out of 10. I don't think it's a bad film. I do think it's a clever film. It's definitely a political film. There is a message in there. I do think it's a cleverly written, nicely, reasonably well directed by Ike Barinholtz and well acted by everybody to a large degree. It just didn't work, which is a bit of a shame. So there you go. That's The Oath, a film that none of us have heard of. I've just managed to see it now. And give it a go. If you like political type movies, it might be for you, might not. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time on Screen Stars.